In today's video, we are going to be talking about good and bad cholesterol, why some types of cholesterol are considered to be good and why some are considered to be bad, and whether or not there's more to the story. Having high cholesterol has become synonymous with bad health, but there might be more to the picture than looking at cholesterol as a whole. This is because there are several different types of cholesterol, all with their own roles and that impact us differently. So in today's video, we are going to be simplifying cholesterol and talking about what you should be looking out for when you get your cholesterol lab test results. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name's Kate. I'm a health coach and I post videos on a high fat, nutrient dense way of eating. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, feel free to share, and make sure to subscribe. And make sure to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook where I share new posts every single day. Today's video is sponsored by SelfDecode, a genetics testing and analysis company that gives you personal health recommendations based on your genes. Later in the video, I will be telling you about their lab test analyzer feature, which allows you to upload your lab test results, such as cholesterol, and receive personalized reports and recommendations to optimize your levels. Head to healthcoachkate.com/selfdecodelabs to learn more. We'll start off today talking about what cholesterol is and the different types of it. Then we will go into some misconceptions, and we'll finish off talking about what you should be looking out for when you look at your cholesterol lab results. What is cholesterol? Cholesterol is a type of fat and an essential structural component of human and animal cell membranes. It is found in every single cell in the human body and is important for several functions. Some of the roles it plays include helping your body absorb fat-soluble vitamins A, D, E, and K, creating hormones, especially sex hormones, helping you to synthesize vitamin D, and maintaining cell structure. Now, most of the cholesterol in our bloodstream, which is what is being tested for when we get a cholesterol blood test, is created by our bodies. We can get a small amount of cholesterol from eating animal foods, but increasing or decreasing dietary cholesterol has been shown to only impact blood cholesterol levels marginally. So worrying about eating a low cholesterol diet is a little bit silly because, as I said, most of the cholesterol in our bloodstream is created by our bodies. Types of cholesterol. Now, when cholesterol is referred to as it pertains to our health, it's not the cholesterol itself that people are talking about, it's what's carrying the cholesterol. And this is known as lipoproteins. There are four types of lipoproteins, but the main two tested for are LDL and HDL. And though they are often referred to as bad and good cholesterol, both are important for our health. LDL is responsible for carrying cholesterol particles to where they need to be throughout the body. And HDL goes around and picks up excess cholesterol and brings it to the liver, where it can be used or excreted. So neither is necessarily good or bad, both do play a role, although LDL does have a pretty bad rep. So let's talk about that now. Cholesterol misconceptions. Here's where things start to get a bit tricky. Having high LDL has been associated with a greater risk of heart disease, and that is why there are concerns over having high cholesterol. But looking at LDL alone is not a good indicator of heart disease risk, or even our overall health in general. Studies that have found an association between high LDL and heart disease have found just that, an association. The reality is that over 75% of people who suffer a heart attack actually have what is considered to be normal LDL levels. In one study where they lowered the LDL of some participants into a range considered to be optimal, after 3 years, the total mortality was twice as high as compared to the group with the higher LDL. And it is well known that for people over the age of 60, having higher LDL is actually associated with a lower all-cause mortality. There is a stronger association between people with insulin resistance and heart attacks than high LDL and heart attacks. Although insulin resistance is something that often goes undiagnosed, so this connection is missed. The point is that looking at LDL alone is not telling us much about our heart disease risk. Now, before I get into some of the better markers of health you can look for on your cholesterol test, I'm going to take a quick moment to tell you about today's sponsor, SelfDecode. Self-Decode is a genetics testing and analysis company, but they also offer online lab test analysis as well. Their lab test analyzer feature allows you to upload your lab test and receive personalized reports and recommendations to optimize your levels. So often our lab test results are compared to standard reference ranges, and those reference ranges might not be applicable to you. Self-Decode uses the latest peer-reviewed research to identify the optimal ranges for your personal test results, so you can lower your risk of disease. They are currently able to analyze over 500 lab markers, everything from cholesterol to nutrient levels, thyroid hormones, and more. Choose from either their annual, lifetime, or professional plan to analyze your test results today. You can head to healthcoachkate.com/selfdecodelabs to check them out. Thanks again to Self-Decode for sponsoring this video. Triglyceride to HDL ratio. So what is a better indicator of your heart disease risk if looking at your total cholesterol or your LDL cholesterol isn't enough? As previously mentioned, being insulin resistant significantly increases your heart disease risk, along with your risk of developing type 2 diabetes, dementia, PCOS, and more. But if you are looking at your cholesterol panel, there are two other numbers you want to look out for that can give you a better sense of your heart disease risk and your overall health. These numbers are triglycerides and HDL. Triglycerides are the amount of fat in your blood. And as we already discussed, HDL is the type of cholesterol that picks up excess cholesterol and brings it to the liver. So triglycerides you want to be lower, ideally less than 1.7 millimolars per liter or 150 milligrams per deciliter. And HDL you want to be higher, ideally over 1 millimolar per liter or 50 milligrams per deciliter. And these are the reference ranges that practitioners often recommend, although for some reason they choose to focus on LDL alone, even if your triglycerides and HDL are optimal. The ratio between triglycerides and HDL cholesterol has actually been shown to be a much better indicator of heart disease risk, with one meta-analysis concluding, although some lipid variables were associated with the extent of coronary disease, the ratio of triglycerides to HDL cholesterol showed the strongest association with extent. A ratio under 1.9 is considered to be optimal, a ratio of 2 to 3 indicates moderate heart disease risk, and a ratio over 3 is a strong indicator of heart disease risk. And these numbers are also an indicator of how insulin resistant you are. That's how much these two things are connected. And one last thing I want to note is that when you're calculating the ratio between triglycerides and HDL, make sure you are calculating it in milligrams per deciliter and not millimolars per liter, or else the calculation won't work out. So in summary, looking at your total cholesterol or LDL cholesterol alone is not a good indicator of heart disease risk or your overall health. Looking at your triglyceride to HDL ratio is a much better indicator. Anyways, guys, that is all I have for you today. Let me know in the comment section down below if you calculate your triglyceride to HDL ratio and what number you get. And remember to check out Self-Decode for genetics testing and lab test analysis. I will put the link to their website in the description box down below. Thanks guys for watching. If you did enjoy this video, you might also like my video on how you can increase your HDL cholesterol. You can check that out right here. If you want to catch up on my most recent upload, you can find it here. And if you want to check out my keto diet and carnivore diet coaching programs, you can do that here. Thanks guys. I'll see you next time. Bye.